A ver, Cactus, quédate quieto un momento.
For those who didn't know about what had transpired in the beginning of this month, my previous video, The Tragedy Behind Astroworld, link in the description below, go watch the video, because this video is the aftermath of what had happened in the Astroworld event. So then, for those who want to know what happened after Astroworld, this video will cover that. I'll quickly summarize in this video what happened on the 5th of November. This event was one of the most tragic incidents in recent time. The rapper known as Travis Scott had a concert in Houston, Texas, where 50,000 people were attending. This concert turned out to be one of the most dangerous and deadly concerts because hundreds of people were injured and maybe even thousands, and sadly 10 people have lost their lives. Still, my condolences go out to everyone affected by the tragedy. This concert was chaotic and pretty dangerous for everyone involved, where fans were excited to meet their favorite rapper, Travis Scott, and in the process were being very rowdy and dangerous. Many things went wrong, from people breaking down the gate to the concert and many people going past security checkpoints with no regard to security or authority. Keep in mind, this all happened before the concert started. From the beginning, the crowd was showing a lot of reckless and chaotic behavior. This chaos only got worse when Travis showed up during the concert. People were packed together and others were passing out. There are multiple clips of people begging for help, people passing out on the floor, multiple phone calls to emergency services, and people begging for the concert to stop. But sadly, the concert didn't stop, and Travis Scott kept the concert going even after causing several casualties. Eventually, Travis Scott made a public apology video that was pretty bad, but was rather unconvincing, and everyone on the internet clowned it due to it being a terrible apology. After the concert, about $2 billion in lawsuits came to Travis Scott for the Astroworld event. An attorney representing more than 200 alleged victims filed a $2 billion lawsuit against Travis for damages, according to the Rolling Stone, which was written about a week ago as of this time of recording. Houston Public Media released an article about the lawsuit against Travis Scott, Drake, Live Nation, Apple, and NRG Stadium. This article actually shows a copy of the lawsuit against which was written by Texas attorney Thomas Henry. A link to the article is available along with the lawsuit. And yes, I did go over this lawsuit. It is 31 pages long, and almost 300 plaintiffs are cited in this document. The document goes over what had transpired. The document states, and I quote, "Defendants were negligent for inciting a riot and violence." They also go on to claim that the defendant encouraged and allowed the subject premise to become overcrowded and filled beyond capacity. This is rather long, but the gist of it is that the defendants were responsible for everything that transpired due to their negligence. Many people were hurt and some died at this concert. At the time of editing, this is where the article states that the lawsuit went up to $3 billion, according to Yahoo Finances. Now, you're wondering what will happen to Travis Scott. Will there be a way out of this because things aren't looking too good for him? Will Travis have to pay compensation to the people that were harmed during the concert? XXL Magazine wrote about the lawsuit. According to attorney Brian Sullivan of Early Sullivan, Wright, Kaiser, McRae, he is referring to the $750 million lawsuit recently filed by Houston lawyer Tony Busby on behalf of 125 victims. He said that it would be difficult to hold Travis Scott liable in court because the plaintiff will have to prove that Travis Scott had incited violence. Sullivan also says he can be a very violent person in an area where there is a fight, but not have thrown a punch. And he adds, "The law requires him to engage in specific conduct that incited the incident. So there is a very low chance that Travis will face repercussions due to this. The only way he would ever get arrested or even charged is if there was more damning evidence." Now, you may be thinking that Travis got away with it scot-free, but that's not how it works, because even if he doesn't have to pay anything, it will be a lot more difficult to get books for the future. Or another option would be that added security and special insurance would be paid out of Travis Scott's own pocket. Travis and his team have refunded tickets for those who attended, as well as paying for the funeral of those who had died. He is also partnering up with BetterHelp to offer free one-on-one online therapy to those who are devastated and in need of mental help after the incident. Along with Travis Scott's reaction to this information, there have been a lot of people on social media talking about how Travis Scott is innocent in all of this. Please don't make it a point to bully anyone. My job here is to give you the information of what's happened. Please don't attack the people I showed in this video. People are defending Travis Scott's action and claim that he wasn't paying attention to the crowd. This video was made during the Travis Scott incident, where it shows a woman standing in front of the cameraman, alerting the cameraman about people passing out during the concert. You can see that the woman and the cameraman are arguing about how the concert needs to be stopped, and the cameraman is telling her to go away. Sadly, in the comments section, there are people defending Travis Scott. There are also conspiracy theories out there saying that Travis Scott was sacrificing people. This is a rather infuriating topic that has been around the internet from Twitter to TikTok. Whether this is true or not isn't irrelevant to the issue, but it is rather infuriating to see people tie religion or conspiracy theories to a tragic accident. But then again, we are used to people doing that for attention, so take it as you will. Wherever you go, there will be people defending their favorite celebrities, whether they are in the right or wrong. and you can believe whatever you want, but please make it a point not to bully anyone who is against Travis Scott, or for that matter, who are supporting Travis Scott. My final thoughts on the Travis Scott incident in the aftermath is there was no other way to describe it but a tragedy. Once again, my thoughts and prayers go out to the families and individuals who have lost a loved one during this tragedy of a concert. Eventually, Travis Scott made a public apology video that was pretty bad and unconvincing to everyone on the internet. After the tragedy, about $2 billion in lawsuits came to Travis Scott for the Astroworld event. In addition to that, almost 300 plaintiffs are cited in lawsuits against Travis Scott, Drake, Live Nation, Apple, and NRG Stadium. As of recording, the amount of plaintiffs will only rise and begin to conclude as the Astroworld lawsuit seems to head into a conclusion. Honestly, someone needs to be held accountable, and only time will tell who and which party is to blame in order to begin making repercussions to the victims involved in the Astroworld tragedy and families of the victims. If you liked today's video, please give it a like, and if you're new, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Got an early fan fucking on a succubus. I feel like I'm Devil Man. Bloody when I'm up.